Another hammer falls on recreational use of RC aircraft or drones in the USA as the National Park Service issues a system-wide ban. Not wanting to miss a chance to assert itself, the Federal Aviation Administration also issues a new interpretation of its authority over model aircraft operators. I've got all the details for you right after this. Welcome to AeroSpaceNews.com, coming to you direct from a secure location deep beneath Area 51. Here you'll find stories on tactics, leading-edge technology, major milestones, hot picks, and beautiful flight video, your basic airplane, helicopter, and spaceflight porn. I'm Craig, editor and publisher, and it's all my fault. I'm somewhat surprised it has taken so long for this to happen, but no matter, the time has come. On 20 June 2014, just in case you're watching this from the future, the U.S. National Park Service Director Jonathan Jarvis signed a policy memorandum that directs superintendents nationwide to prohibit launching, landing, or operating unmanned aircraft on lands and waters administered by the National Park Service, according to a statement issued by the agency. It said that visitor safety and park resources concerns prompted the new policy directive. What that means in plain language is that the agency claims there have been at least three incidents where RC pilots have behaved badly, and that justifies this blanket ban. According to the Park Service, in September 2013, an unmanned aircraft flew above evening visitors seated in the Mount Rushmore National Memorial Amphitheater. In April 2014, visitors at Grand Canyon National Park gathered for a quiet sunset, which was interrupted by a loud unmanned aircraft flying back and forth and eventually crashing in the canyon. And later that same month, volunteers at Zion National Park witnessed an unmanned aircraft disturb a herd of bighorn sheep, reportedly separating adults from young animals. Aspects of this are not actually new. Some national parks already banned RC flying, as one might expect in places that are supposed to be pristine sanctuaries for nature and its enjoyment. There is already tension in this regard with full-scale aircraft flown over national parks, both to transit the airspace and those operated by tour companies. The Park Service says this directive is temporary, but only until a final regulation takes the long-haul journey through the public process. But for now, all existing permits for unmanned aircraft flights will be suspended until reviewed and approved anew by the Associate Director of the Park Service's Visitor and Resource Protection Directorate. Oh, but in the Do As I Say But Not As I Do department, the agency says that it may use unmanned aircraft for administrative purposes such as search and rescue, fire operations, and scientific study. Those uses must also be approved by the Associate Director for Visitor and Resource Protection. So there is that. Not to be outdone, the Federal Aviation Administration issued a statement on 23 June 2014 titled, FAA Offers Guidance to Model Aircraft Operators. The subtitle was definitely less gentle, stating that the, quote, agency issues interpretation of 2012 reauthorization law restates authority to take enforcement action against hazardous operations. The motivation for the action, according to the FAA, was due to, quote, recent incidents involving the reckless use of unmanned model aircraft near airports and involving large crowds of people, close quote. That grammar is wrong. It should say most recent incidents. That's because anybody paying attention knows that reckless use of unmanned model aircraft has been going on quite a lot, and the FAA only now, like a sleeping giant, is waking up to that fact. Friends, do not misunderstand what I just said. I fly RC, and it was my start in aviation at 14 years old. But any rational person could not help but conclude from the evidence easily available on YouTube alone that there are some in the USA who fly RC airplanes, helicopters, and multicopters in a reckless manner, endangering themselves, others, and the hobby. The vast majority of the RC hobbyists are fun-loving, responsible, community-oriented, and very generous with their time and knowledge. It's a small percentage that are bad actors, but the size of that group is unfortunately growing. Back to the FAA. Sadly, they are continuing what seems to me to be a little communication bipolar disorder. On the one hand, they reassert the agency's authority over hobby use of RC with statements like, quote, compliance with these rules for model aircraft operators has been required since the act was signed on February 14, 2012, and the explanation provided today does not change that fact, close quote. On the other hand, the published guidance says, quote, hobby or recreational flying doesn't require FAA approval, but you must follow safety guidelines, close quote. Perhaps the most important takeaway from today's FAA announcement is the restatement of the banned activities when using RC aircraft, according to the FAA anyway. Drum roll, please. Don't fly near manned aircraft. Don't fly beyond line of sight of the operator. Don't fly an aircraft weighing more than 55 pounds unless it's certified by an aeromodeling community-based organization. Don't fly contrary to your aeromodeling community-based safety guidelines. Don't fly a model aircraft for payment or commercial purposes. By the way, did you know the FAA wants you to contact any airport or control tower within 5 miles of wherever you plan to fly any RC aircraft? They don't say if those are statute or nautical miles, just that you're supposed to get in touch and let them know before you fly. What do you think? Please leave a polite comment or question here on YouTube or over at AeroSpaceNews.com. We may even start a comment contest, but don't hold your breath. To keep up with the latest breaking news and amazing flight videos, subscribe to our channel and follow us on Twitter at AeroSpaceNews, all one word. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on the Leading Edge at the Hyperdrive Heavy Maintenance Expo on Tatooine.